It was an excellent event, a good initiative by Mr. Daga and IMC. Today the role of cotton growers, as well as there is no integration between all the stakeholders. What today we achieved, everybody from different area, they come together and everybody is working on the progressive roadmap. That is the most important part, because everyone is expecting something good, but nothing concrete is coming out of conferences and lot many efforts through policies. So this is the particular conclave can guide the entire industry, as well as the bottom of the pyramid, the farmer, as well as the genus, as well as the spinning units and other area of cotton growth. And most important part is such kind of initiatives will boost the confidence of common man. I'm from Vidarbha. We have taken an initiative related to cotton Vidarbha, and that cotton Vidarbha initiative is also required help from all of the stakeholders from this region. And most of the people are started delivering on issues like contamination and poor quality of cotton supply and productivity and quality and research and development. If everything is clubbed together, the price will not be an issue, a problem for the grower, as well as the demand will also match the complete expectation of the world. Thank you very much.
I want to compliment COTTONGURU, in particular Manish Daga, for joining hands with the IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry Economic Research and Training Foundation to do this seminar, which is an extraordinarily important stakeholder consultation. We are trying to discover cotton economics and to suggest ways and means of strengthening the cotton sector. Cotton has delivered extraordinary value to stakeholders over the last 15 years or so. India is now the world's largest producer and largest exporter of cotton. I think this is a position which we owe actually to the cotton growers of India, cotton farmers of India. Cotton farmers have been complaining that they are not receiving appropriate returns or adequate returns. There are also cases of suicide that we hear, most unfortunately. There is a strong need to strengthen the cotton value chain, capture maximum value out of this white gold. It's such a wonder crop that the stakeholder consultation has thrown up a very large number of suggestions and recommendations, and all this is going to be converted into a white paper, and obviously this will be submitted to policy makers. The policy makers, the government, both the central government and various state governments, have a significant role to play in strengthening the cotton sector. The farmers, ginners, processors, textile mills, traders, and a whole lot of others also have a significant role to play in strengthening the supply chain as also the value chain. We will hopefully soon come out with a white paper with a series of recommendations, and I have no doubt in my mind that if these recommendations are followed and implemented, there will be a substantial increase in the income for farmers growing cotton, as also we would discover various value addition possibilities, and it will be a win-win for all the stakeholders. Thank you.
Really happy to be here today in Cotton Conclave 2018. It was a very different experience, and I'm very glad that it could be executed the way it was supposed to be done. Very professionally, very disciplined, and we had people from all walks of the cotton industry, which is very important, because everyone has his own perspective and his own view, and it's very important to understand everyone's perspective and view to come out with any comprehensive framework and balancing everyone's interest and prejudice without being prejudiced or biased to anyone else. So Cotton Conclave was very concise, and good thing it was for 20 to about 3 hours, and we were able to cover up and get about 40-50 points, which have been tabulated and grouped together to form a basis on which the industry, the government, and the farmers, and all other intermediaries and consultants, etc., involved in the industry, would work together towards the common good. It's not only doubling the farmers' income, it will help everyone right up to the end of the value chain. And we, being from the value chain, are hope for the best for everyone here. Thank you.
In nutshell, the program attended by me up till now are in hundreds in number, but this is the only program where the time management was excellent and all the topics are covered to the point. There is no unnecessary extension of any session. So keep it up, and in future also will love to attend this program if the time management is maintained. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it was a wonderful conclave with a lot of collection of ideas, and the white paper which has been prepared after the brainstorming which just happened would be would go a long way in ensuring that our India gains its mileage in cotton production, and textile industry also is bound to do well if the production level and the growth of cotton is going to be competitive across the country. And so I wish that all the people who are stakeholders in this meeting as well as participants would take these suggestions forward and help the country become very powerful in terms of textile industry.
Thank you so much.
Actually, when I came for this conference, I was having very little hopes that something will happen drastically. But when I came in with Manish Daga's, you know, whatever the way he has conducted it, it was an innovative idea in textile industry that somebody is coming out with a white paper immediately after the conference. And that too, taking inputs from the farmers, taking inputs from the industry as well as from the various types of stakeholders. So it was well done, nicely done.
I was pleasantly surprised. You know, I came to this event not knowing really what to expect. And of course, when I came here, I saw all the stakeholders. And the one thing I was pleasantly surprised is that it was actually resonating that, yeah, a lot of the problems can be solved when you go right to the source of the problem, which is on the farm. And of course, people had various different ideas how to go about solving it. But at least there is a unison. Okay. Now the challenge is that even if you are able to kind of execute or implement even, you know, 30% of whatever you know, suggestions have come through, because, and here every stakeholder was present, right from, we had farmers, we had ginners, we had mill owners, we had scientists, you know, government, bureaucracy, everybody. So all the suggestions that have come through are absolutely bang on. Okay, the only thing that I hope to see is action, okay, on these various different suggestions that have been put forth. And I kind of get a feeling that the challenge really is going to be in the implementation of this, is going to be giving the extension services to the farmer, okay, and how we are going to do that. I mean, what are the agencies that are going to be involved, whether it's the government or whether it's an agency like the Better Cotton Initiative or maybe even the individual gin owner. Okay, something I have no answers for, because I'm actually not an expert on the entire value chain of cotton. But definitely what came across is that we are in the red zone. Okay, we better pick up and do something about this whole problem. If we don't, then we are going to lose our pole position in India as a great cotton producing nation, because things have not improved significantly over the past few years. That's the kind of feeling that I got. So I'm looking forward for all these things to be implemented and actually seeing a good roadmap and success of this whole industry. Thank you.
Thank you.